Today we're going to an army base for the vet visit. Tantan, our cute kitty. Tantan, need a vet today, huh?
So, there are 5 steps for a pet to go to Japan. The vlog you're watching today is about the 5th one, which is the last step, health certificate. But before this, we actually have done 4 other things, which I'm going to tell you guys. First, make sure your pet have microchip. We got her from a shelter, so the shelter already put microchip in her, so we didn't have to worry too much about it. Make sure your pet started to have vaccination after you put in the microchip. Second step is you need 2 rabies vaccines. First, make sure your pet is, or at least cat, you have to be like 91 years old.
What? Bro, what are you talking about, man?
No, no, why? 91 days old before they receive the first vaccine. And both vaccines has to be 30 days apart. When you receive the second vaccine, the first one cannot be expired. Both of her vaccines are like 3 years vaccine, so we never run into that problem. Even though there are 3 years, you still have to do 2. And number 3 is the Favin test, which is also called the rabies antibody test. It is possible to have it done the same day as your second rabies vaccine, but we waited for 21 days to see if the second vaccine kicked in. We had a very tight timeline, so we cannot risk her to fail on the Favin test, because that test take like 4 to 6 weeks to get the result. We got it pretty fast, like 3-4 weeks. This is kind of expensive. We did it with a civilian vet, and it cost us $240 to have the Favin test and the FedEx. But I heard on the military base vet will be a lot cheaper. I'm not sure if that's true or not. Number 4 is a quarantine. Your pet needs 180 days of quarantine. I think it's easy on cat, because our cat is an indoor cat. We never let her go out. But with dogs, might be harder because you have to walk them. I don't know how that works with the dogs. Since we're moving with a military purpose, the 180 days are not as strict. She can just continue her quarantine on base. The last step is this health certificate. This is kind of tricky and kind of like a pain in the butt. You cannot do health certificate unless it's within 10 days before your travel date. For example, if your travel date is May 1st, you cannot do health certificate until May 1st. Does it make sense? Moving is already crazy and everything is already like stressful. And then you have to like, within those 10 days, you have to go to a vet. Better to be on base vet, because all the vet on base are USDA approved. So they can give you health certificate without additional steps. If you go to a civilian that's not approved by USDA, they might have to send it to somewhere else to get approved. That's why we drove 2 hours to another base that have vet facility to get her health certificate. Worth the time, worth the effort, but just a little bit painful because we're already in the middle of moving and just really stressful. I speak from my experience, so maybe not perfectly correct. This is how we get our cat ready for go to Japan with us. I think dogs are similar process. The biggest advice I would give you guys is start early. I mean, if you start early, even you make mistakes, it's really easy to fix and you don't have to stress so much. I'll put some links down below in the description box so you can look through it, find details yourself, make sure everything is up to date, and I think you'll be okay. Alright, go back to the vlog.
This is the kennel or carrier we prepared for her. Come in here. Here. Can you go in?
Oh my gosh. I got her.
Thank you very much. Enzo.
Hey!
Tantan, no. What are you doing? Are you mad?
Alright, Tantan, you're kind of heavy.
Alright. It's kind of heavy, huh, Tantan? Be with mommy in the front seat. Her face looks so sad. You're okay, baby. I open this for you, okay? Figure this out. You can expand it, and she's mad at me. And now we're going, and it says 2:17. Our appointment is at 1, and ETA is 12:30. Got here after 2 hours. Tantan, you okay? I don't think we can film inside, so I'm just going to tell you how it goes when we come out. I have to pee so bad. The baby is kicking my bladder right now. This is the vet, looks like. They're nice to you, huh? Hey, thank you for being good, baby.
Just finished our appointment. Tantan, that's so good, huh? And now we're at exchange. There's a tropical smoothie cafe in there, but it's kind of hot. I might take her with me. Tantan, you ready for our adventure? No, I'm starving. It's like almost 2 o'clock and I haven't eaten my lunch. So yeah, let's go in there with Tantan because it's just way too hot for her to stay in the car.
excited. Here you go. Thank you for being a good kitty today, baby.